to me that I will be a pastor. I went to different churches. They prophesied to me that I will be a pastor. But I stopped going to church for around three years. Now I came back to this church, another church. My father prophesied to me I will be a pastor. I don't know what I can say. I stood again. I said to myself, I don't want to be a pastor, but anything I do, I will still go back. I'll go back to my memory that I will be a pastor, but I don't know how I will start to be that pastor, to go to that way. That I'm begging my father, please direct me
directs you on what to do in the name of Jesus. Yeah. Hallelujah. Special number.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
My special number talks about He is a God. He is a God and He never will be. Hallelujah. There is no one like our God.
To feed the sheep. Please take care of him. Power. Feed the sheep. Feed the sheep. Feed the sheep. Feed the sheep. There are sheep that are collapsing. They are giving up on the faith. Nobody is there to take care of them. There are people who are there in the house of God. They have no hope. There is no one to feed them. Where is the ministry of follow-up? People are backsliding. Nobody is following them up. Who is after the lost sheep? Who is after those people who used to come to the church and they are no longer coming to the church? Who is after the people who started looking for the word of God and they were not whatever? Who is after the lordship? Can I look for the David? There is a one that was giving my fathership. A lion came after it. I went after it and I pulled it. Am I talking? That means the sheep, there are lions that are coming after some sheep. And there are some wolves coming after some sheep. And there are some bears coming after the sheep. We can be in church here, but there are people that lions are after them. We can be in church here, there are people that the wolves is after them. We can be in church here, there are people that the bear is after them. It takes a leader, an administrator to look at a young girl. I see you going where we'll come here. Am I talking to somebody here? I see you going like this. There is an attack of the devil on your destiny. You are trying to stabilize the young sheep, the young sheep, the young sheep. Stretch your hands and Father, grace for the young sheep. Let me not lose the young sheep. Who is after the young sheep? A man who is after the father's assignment. Why some are going there looking on the streets to bring the lost? Some are within the corridors of the house of God, strengthening the lordship, making sure they are rescuing the long sheep from the mouth of lions, the light of power. There are people who come into the church just to look for sisters. There are people who come to the church to look for skirts. There are people who come to the church to sponsor immoralities. There are people who come within the church to sponsor all kinds of rough things, wrong things in the house of God. Are there some watchmen in this house that can watch over some sheep? Am I talking to somebody here? Is there a mother here who can watch over the wrong, the young sheep? Are there some men that can watch over some young sheep? Somebody say, after the father's assignment. And I'm not talking, right? I told her when I'll be done with you, you know that I'm done. As I'm speaking, when was the last time you went to the Ministry of Encouragement? When was the last time you went and gave somebody money, say, I see you, you are almost giving up in the faith because of small 500 or transport money. Let me pay your bills for about 1 year. Let me pay you to learn work for 2 years. It's just 3,000 to go learn some simple hairdressing or whatever. 3,000 times 12 is 36,000, is no money. I spent, only money I spent on transport is something else. The little things. When was the last time you held a young girl who came to the church with a child on her hand, and before she knew the Lord, she had messed up her life, and she had a child, a young girl babysitting another young child, and you pay the child primary school education, it's just barely 5,000. Sew a small uniform for 3,000 and buy a small book. You must have invested for a kingdom assignment. If that child was supposed to backslide, someone has taken that bullet. Am I speaking to somebody? Who is a David here? We have lost the focus. We are fighting titles and fighting positions, and we have left the functions. We have left the place of the responsibility. We've allowed the enemy to delay our focus. Can I make it better?
Yes, sir.
When David went after their father's assignment, what did he recover? Somebody say his destiny.
His destiny.
Kingship.
Kingship.
He was going for a lordship. Behind the lordship was his kingship. Behind the lordship was a place where every person, the president of the nation, that was tied to behind being after the father's assignment. There was a diplomatic position for him just be after the Father's assignment. There was an honorable seat in the entire nation of Israel for him. He said, the Lord has spoken to Samuel a day before, I will send a young man to you. How did the Lord send the young man? Through the Father's assignment. As you are walking, looking for the Lordship, the Lord has technically set up a destiny for you. The Lord has set someone that will carry you into a position of honor and glory. I wish I had a young girl or a young woman. Who will leave this meeting today? He said, every week I'm going down for the Father's assignment. Because behind the Father's assignment is a throne. It's a throne. A throne for marriage. A throne for money. A throne for big things. A throne for glorious things. Our God is a God of setup. He sets things and hides them. I said, you know, what was the last time that you wake up this morning and begin to go under the Father's assignment? As a young boy, I was in the University of Swa, morning, night, going under the Father's assignment. Little did I know that God will lift me up the way He has lifted me. Little did I know that God made a father to God, members of government and administrators, but under the Father's assignment. Working under the Father's assignment, doors began opening. Before I knew, I had a scholarship with the World Bank Institute. Before I knew, doors began opening to places. But I was always antedate. I am an addict to the Father's assignment. I am an addict to the Father's assignment. Everywhere you see me, you will always see me after the Father's assignment. Under the Father's assignment. Principle of recovery. Have you lost your home? Get serious with God. Have you lost your marital life? Get under the Father's assignment. Is your business not working? Get under the Father's assignment. What is not working right around your life? Get under the Father's assignment. There is a throne. I said there is a throne. Man of God, there is a throne. There is a throne. Under the Father's assignment, there is a throne. What is still under the, when you're under the Father's assignment? The anointing. The anointing always finds the heads of people who are under the Father's assignment. And somewhere arrived the house, there were seven sons that they led them to pass through. And even when he struggled to say, Ella, you are the one, the oil did not flow. He was in the house, but not doing something for the Father. There are many people in the house of God, just warming seeds in the house of God. And they are not instrumental in the hand of God. You are not hearing. Even the man of God is trying to force the oil. God says, no, the one who is out there working is the one who qualifies for the oil. The one who is out there building, rescuing ships is the one that the oil flows on their head. They have done all the things to ensure that the oil flows, your head is not flowing. The problem is not the altar. The problem is not that Samuel is not anointed. The problem is your non-usefulness to the kingdom assignment. The oil flows and recommending on the heads that are under the Father's assignment. This is not what you came to hear today, right? I'm sure this is not what you came to hear. And you actually don't know where I'm coming from. The anointing locates only heads that are under the Father's assignment. It locates Saul's head. And an oil was poured, 1 Samuel chapter 10, on the head because it was under what? The Father's assignment. David was not even in the house. There were people in the house. The oil came, refused to flow. Hey. God came into the house. This means that this morning, that God has come with the horn of oil that is going to know whether your heart can change today. If your heart can turn and you make a covenant with God this morning, I promise you, when I was praying for this meeting, I saw 24 people. The Lord said to me that He's going to pour oil on their head. And it depends on your heart condition this hour. If you make up your mind and consider your ways and repent from your heart and say, Father, I want to live for your fruitfulness. I want to live for your impact. I want to live to touch the world for you. I want to live to make men know you. I want to live that the world will know you have a child of the Lord. I want to live dedicating my time, my resources, my skills for the advancement and the furtherance of your work. Am I talking to someone here? Am I talking to someone here?
Lift up your hands here. Father, that horn I saw. That horns that I saw, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You showed me a woman prophesying like the days of David, singing and prophesying with the kind of anointing, casting out devils through the voice of the Spirit. And you said, when I come to the meeting, I began to speak, the oil will fall. Where is that woman? You take that woman out. Speak it. Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Help this girl, help this girl. I see a psalmist anointing falling. A psalmist anointing falling. A psalmist anointing. My God, my God, my God. There is a man of God falling. I see an anointing. Hey, Jesus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Jesus. The sun is anointed. Let some men and women become useful. Hey. I see a young man receiving power. Power. Jesus, I'm not saying power. My God.
Get out from that country.
ground. Sit down. Sit down. Let me wipe this thing out.
Thank you.
see God like you have never seen him. And that's why if I want to give to God, I give to God a month. When I gave a land for God, somebody asked me, you give a land for God? I said, it's God. I was a young, broke guy. God met me and helped me. Anything he has, let him carry. It's my father. I love him with a passion. And I told him that I was one time I met a young man who said he has given for God. I told him to count how much he has given to God for 6 months. I want to pay him the money back. Stupid giving. Emotional giving. Can you give for God? Can you help God? Do you have anything you can give to God? Does God need money? The cat to support the thousand, he belongs to God. The edges of the Lord and the fullness thereof and all that dwells within it belongs to God. When you come to church, you came to see Jesus. Don't think that you can only have bad friends outside. You can have bad friends inside the house of God. The son of David, the first son by name Ammon, 2 Samuel chapter 13, had a brother, Jonadab. Say maybe he was an uncle or whatever. Jonadab, he was inside the king's palace, inside the same family compound that boy lost his life. Told the uncle that I'm having a feeling, emotional thought I'm feeling towards my sister Tamar. Am I talking to somebody here? The uncle advised him how to perform a wrong thing. Where did he get it? From outside the palace? Or from within the palace? Inside the palace. There are people inside the house of God that can kill your destiny. And that boy died. He was the apparent heir to the throne. He missed the throne because of wrong association. Not from outside, wrong association. Some of you are here. When you see someone walking wrongly in the house of God, what do you do? Withdraw yourself. What should you do? Withdraw yourself. Are you here? Are you hearing me? Therefore, someone asked me, number one, who are the kind of people I should associate with? It's in the text. Number one, associate with people when you want to give up, they tell you don't give up. When Saul wanted to give up and said, let's return, the man said, we are not returning. I need that kind of people in my life. When I want to give up, they look at me and say, please don't give up. When I want to go back and backslide, they say, no, we are not backsliding. We are not going back. When you want to surrender, they say, we are not surrendering. Am I speaking to somebody here? Yes. Am I talking to someone here? Yes. Associate to that kind of people. Can I give you number two?
Yes.
Want to hear number two?
Yes.
Little people that takes you closer to men of God. There is a prophet in this city. Let's go to him. Look for people that draw you closer to God and his servants. Any man in the house of God taking you away from God, taking you away from his servant, are enemies to your future. You are not getting what I'm talking about. Are you all hear what I'm saying? Tell me about that. Am I the one who wrote it? Any man or woman in the house of God that is trying to draw you from God and his servant is an enemy to your future, to your process of total recovery. Because the servant of God has the word from God for your destiny. Am I speaking to somebody here? That's what happened. Number two people you should do what? Anybody that takes you closer to God's servant, closer to God, is someone you should do what? Associate with. While in your workplace, your business, whatever you are doing in life, there are people you can run away from. Number three, people who are willing to invest their resources to your cause. What you are pursuing in life. They say, Paul, Saul said, we don't have anything. The person said, I have something. I don't mind, I'll put it for the cause. The recovery, we are here on a mission to recover the lost ass. people who are willing to invest their resources to your cause. You're not getting what I'm talking about. Am I speaking to somebody here? People who are willing to invest their resources to your kingdom dream. People who are willing to invest their resources to your project, to your vision, to your ministerial plans, to church missions, church goals. What should you do? Associate with them. I'm already preaching many messages here. Number four. How many have I given already? There are many I can give you until you don't know what to do. Can I add it? He said, there is a man in this city. Same information. In other words, Saul is in the richest family, richest home, but he's not informed. But his servant has information. Associate with people who are informed. Because information is the gateway to transformation. Information is the vehicle that drives you to a triumphant life. People who bring you information that can sponsor your recovery. People who bring information that can sponsor your course of life. Associate with them. Am I preaching to somebody here?
Yes.
Am I talking to someone?
Yes.
There is a company that is hiring people. There is an opportunity here. There is this kind of thing here. The man of God is coming here. There is an anointing here. The woman will never say, hey, that there is. She heard. Because the information you hear is very strong. For today, let's leave it there. Under the point of association. The last point. We read on verse 14, verse 15. Verse 14 and 15, we read it there. It says, as they approach the city, here comes Samuel coming. The man of God. It says, there is an honorable man of God. I'm giving you 2 points, although there are sub-points under. Be after the Father's assignment if you want to recover. Number two, build a right relationship or right association. Am I talking to somebody here? And the last one, honor your prophet. Who told them that the donkeys were found? We read it. Who told him?
The
seer. Who told him about his throne? There is an honorable man of God in this city. If you find him, you find your lost ass. If you find him, you find your throne. Not every man is sent to speak to your life. There are sent people into your life. If you joke with that relationship, you joke with your destiny. I repeat it again. Not every man of God is sent to your life. When you meet the one sent to your life, the evidence cannot be denied. Christians are spiritual prostitutes. Today that with this man of God, tomorrow that with this man of God, Father's time that with this man of God, they are moving like circles. They are not moving like this. They say, my little children, don't be toasted through and through. When you're moving that kind of life, it means that you are immature. You are immature in the faith. Little children, toasted, little children. The one that they can have the rest is they are toasted. They are dangling. They are unstable. They are unstable. Today they are here, tomorrow they stand for this, 5 days stand, they stand for this, 3 months stand, they stand for this, 6 months stand, they stand for here. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to somebody here? Bible says, you shall be planted in the house of God. And what? You shall do what? Flourish. So until you are planted, flourishing is not your portion. You are planted that sponsors your flourishing. If God has sent you here, make up your mind to listen to your prophet. There was a man, John chapter 1, verse 4-5, sent from heaven. His name was John. He was a man, the one thing he was sent from heaven. You are not getting what I'm saying. There was a man sent from heaven. His name was John. though he's a man, but he has a kingdom assignment on his life. Your man of God is sent from heaven.
Amen.
The bearer of this vision is sent from heaven.
Amen.
You're not hearing me better.
Amen.
I say you're not hearing me better.
Amen.
Nicodemus met Jesus in John chapter 3, verse 4, 5. He says, no man can do these things except God be with him. You're not hearing me that. That's my name. No man can do what? These things. Except what? Jesus says, if you don't believe me, my works, believe it. Believe my works. If you don't believe you don't believe your primate to plant churches in different nations, the works are on ground to speak for itself. If you fail to believe a person, look at the work and let it sponsor your belief system. There is an honorable man of God. Are you hearing me? It's right inside your text. There is. Every man has a man sent to your life. No matter how you pray, God will send a man. It is illegal for God to act on the face of the earth as a man. God has no legal entry on the face of the earth to operate without man. The cry of my people has come to my ears. The weeping of my people has come to my ears. Moses, I have come down. How did God come down? He came down through a man. The Christianity that teaches you not to see men as channel of divine visitation is a non-Christianity. I can speak to you as an apostle. I have many churches under my custody. And I'll tell you that. I'm leaving here soon. I have 4 services to preach today. Listen very well. Listen, 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 listen. This is the final point I'm inside of my holiday. The soul find the lost ass through the connection of the Lord. 2 Chronicles 20, believe in the Lord your God, thou shalt be established. Believe in his servant the prophet, thou shalt prosper. Your prosperity is in the hands of your same prophet. Believing God sponsor your establishment to advance and prosper and progress in life is your connection to her. Your prophet. There is a sent prophet to you. Hosea 12:13. By a prophet Israel was brought out. By a prophet Israel was preserved. Number one.
You know, whenever you make one, I'm not giving yourself honor now.
There is an honorable man of God in this city. Number one. To show that you draw from a man of God, number one, you must honor a man of God. A prophet without honor. The greatest problem we have today is lack of honor around grace. You hear the grammar, man? The greatest problem we have today is what? Lack of honor around grace. Grace. We are equal in Christianity as new birth. We are not equal in grace. We are not. Jesus Christ was not honored, Mark chapter 6, and therefore he could do not great works. He said, because the people never believe in him. Not that they don't believe in God. They believe in God, but they never believe in their sent prophet. So their disbelief to their sent prophet short-circuited the move of God in their lives. Coming to church and not honoring a man of God is more disadvantageous to your life. Say honor.
Honor.
I'm not hearing you, say honor.
Honor.
Say it again, say honor.
Honor.
You can't give a man of God money without putting an envelope. Let me just do some small business. No, it's disrespect. Say, Papa, no, 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 I just said, no, no, it's disrespect. It's dishonor. Don't hold on. It's dishonor. It's lack of respect. Are you guys saying it?
Yes.
You hear what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
Can I talk some more again?
Yes, sir.
Should I?
Yes.
When grace has blessed you, is blessing you. You can come around grace. Not everybody was around. The 12 were around is Jesus Christ. And then one missed it. Judah missed it. He missed it. The level at which you honor a man of God is the level at which the grace through that man will speak on your life. The car I gave you money, you bought, the one they are working on, the other one, the Nwala. It's one of my daughter that bought that car. The level of honor, doors are opening to her like this. I cannot see them. Anytime God gives you a man of God, honor the man of God. There is an honorable man of God in this city. Number two, you don't meet up, you don't see your prophet empty-handed. So I said, what shall we take for the man of God? He said, there is a law here. Let me tell you, he that gives a cup of water to a prophet receives a prophet reward. Sometimes I don't pray, Papa, I don't pray, no work. How did you approach Papa? How did you approach him? You approach him on the field of honor. I tell people, anyone I preach for the years I have preached the Bible, whether you don't have anything, carry water. Say, Papa, now you don't have it. It's a sign of honor. The water. Carry the water from your house. Say, I have an appointment to go see Papa in the office. This is what you have. It's called the widow's mite. Am I talking to somebody here? Don't take certain things for granted. I don't know how you can read the Bible and don't find secrets. When the secrets are in the word. Sorry, I'm talking about this, not for you. Let me, because let the anointing flow as it's supposed to flow. When that is, why do you think that Isaac wants to transfer the blessing to his own son? The blessing is called the Abrahamic blessing. It was transferred from Abraham to Isaac. That same covenant, he wants to pass it on to Esau. He said, go prepare me something. Because under the principle of the transference of blessings, there is a contact of transmission. So he could go to the extent that even his own son need to fulfill principle before they transfer. A son born in his own loins could honor principle, because the things of the kingdom are not your ways. You don't go like that. You don't go like that. Am I speaking to someone here? We live in an untaught church, untaught dispensation, untaught moment, and many people are missing God. God is here, you can miss him. Oh, tomorrow when I'll be teaching you here, it'll be something else. Don't miss the meeting tomorrow. I'll be here with fresh wine. Very fresh. Listen. Never the widow of Zarephath, 1 Kings chapter 17, had nothing. Whether they last me to give the son, the prophet said, bring it to me. Because it is the contact for overflow.
Amen.
Never approach a man of God. Whether it's your father, the mentality of coming to only collect from the man of God. Please, your blessing is found in your giving. They can give you, but always make sure you connect to that grace. Am I talking to someone here?
Yes.
Are you getting me? It's true, men of God can give. I'm a giver, very good giver. But the more you tap is what you connect to the grace. Say amen.
Amen.
I can't hear you. Say amen.
Amen.
Say amen again.
Amen.
Number three, how do I honor my prophet? Believe his words. The words of your prophet. What should you do? Believe in the Lord your God, 2 Chronicles 20:20, and thou shalt be established. Believe in his prophet. You can't say, I follow a man of God, I don't believe in him. Believe in his word. A man paid flight one time in the scripture in 2 Kings chapter 5. His name was Naaman. He's a colonel in army. Fly from Syria to Jerusalem. That's international, crossing international borders and boundaries. Land into a nation to see a prophet. They gave him a word. He came with gift for the prophet. We should honor the principle there. They gave him a word. Go to the Jordan and die. The God of heaven. Thank God that he had good servants who talked him in. Good servant. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Who talked him in? He would have missed his process of recovery. But his servant spoke to him. If they have asked you something very big to do, would you have done it? Just the simple instruction the man of God gave you. It's simple, but that's the road where the miracle is. It doesn't make sense, but that's the divine pattern.
Don't make sense.
It doesn't make sense. Some of you are too intelligent for God. Your certificates are playing on your head. The small school you have gone, you look like you are too wise. But the wisdom is your foolishness. Because God uses the foolish things of this world, 1 Corinthians chapter 1, to confirm the wisdom. The foolishness of God is greater than your intelligence.
Yes.
I don't want to go far.
It doesn't make sense.
I don't want to go far.
Yes, sir.
For you to see a man, you wake up every day, you're sweeping this church, you're coming. There's nothing in the name of that church. Sweeper, let it not make sense to people.
Yes.
It is making sense to God.
Yes.
Follow a man. Elijah was following a man. They said, don't you know the Lord will take a man? Everywhere he passed, 50 prophets. They said, look at this one. Look at this one. They said, I know all your peace. Many people can talk you out of where you're made, your man of God is. And they are not, there are also people in the house of God.
Yes.
There were other prophets trying to talk him out. Other people who know how to read John chapter 3. And quoting for God so loved the world. When you ask them how they should explain that scripture in context and out of text, post-text and pre-text, they will not be able to stand.
Hey.
Because you hold the Bible, you start reading small the shows of Bible, you thought you have seen God. You have seen a shadow. There are things I don't want to enter there today. See you tomorrow. Do you know Bible says no man, Jesus said it, not if it was a man that said it. Out of Adam, Jesus said, no man has ever seen God.
Yes.
Then what did Moses see?
Shadow.
Jesus said in the New Testament, no man has seen God. Then what did Moses see? There are some things you are seeing now, you think you are seeing God. We will get there someday.
Oh, yes.
For today, that's not where we are. Let's get to our prophets. Instruction. That is the sacred code of recovery, of making life better. Jesus' mother told the disciples, since she knows the code, whatever he tells you, the woman knows that if she leaves, she walks. And said, but this girl and this girl, they don't know this man. Let me give them the secret code.
The key.
Whatever he tells you, though he has not spoken. And you know why he said that? Because what he's about to say will not make sense. Are you going to carry water where they wash feet? And then you pour it and then pour water inside and carry it. And go and give mother his wine. The mother knows that that boy will about say something that will not be mentally make sense. He knows. She knows. And that's why he said, if I leave them, their human intellect can be an obstacle to the miracle that is about to be made. I have placed an expectation to the heavens. I have gone there, the wine is finished. In other words, I have made an intercessory demand that heaven needs to supply. That if heaven needs to supply, man must cooperate. Therefore, the disciples, whatever he tells you, do it. And then she left. Suddenly he turned. He said, go to where they were washing their feet and hands and empty the temple. Empty it, pour water there. They carry it and they come. And he said, okay, take it. You really know that what you are carrying is water. And then they are telling you to carry that jar like this on your hand. To go to an event where there are no common people, there are men of authority like governors. He said to the governor of the event. That means members of government are sitting. And then see yourself carrying water. It is not the amount that you know. They will not just come and give it to you. It's you that really feel the water. And you know that is the content is water. I wish to prophesy. If you want to follow God, kill your mind and allow God lead you. Allow God lead you. Kill some things and allow God to lead you. And you will see wonders. You will see crazy things happening. Anytime a man of God, I have a daughter, one time she told me that somebody has collapsed in their house and the person is not breathing. They feel like the person is dead or whatever. I said, okay, who are the people in your house? I was out of town. She told me the people and some other people. I said, send all of them out of the house. You know what? I asked her to send all the people out of the house. There will be a problem to what is about to happen. She said, me, my mother, I said, all of them, tell them that I said they should go out of the house. Send them all out. They should carry and drop her in the paddock. Let them go out of the house. They carried them, all of them went out of the house. I said, shut the door, shut everywhere. She shut everywhere. I said, Daddy, I've done it. I said, where you are now? Go on top of the baby. Lie. Open your hand over there and breathe on the air of the mouth of the baby. She prayed. I said, do it seven times. She did it. The person, the lady choked and came out. After collapse, I was not talking for almost about 30 minutes. Then they were crying and calling. The lady came out. Now, may I do the miracle? No.
Obey.
It is just the obedience.
Obey.
I was not there. You don't need Pastor Eric to be where you are when there's crisis. If you are a true follower and an instruction is given to you, follow you up. Jesus sent two disciples, go into the city. There is an ass standing by the side of the English. Go and lose it. Anyone that comes, you tell them the master has me. And you know that Jesus does not belong to that village. He does not live there. Neither nor his parents or family live there. And then you are going to untie an ass, and then the ass you say the master need it. Your head correct. And then the guy they just walk to the place. And they untied it. While they untied it, someone asked them. And they said it, the master made it. The man let them go. Believe in the instructions. I was talking early this morning, one of my sons is flying to Sweden next 2 weeks. He applied for admission before the COVID thing got so serious. Admission letters came out during the COVID period. He was admitted. And then when the issue began getting serious, countries began closing their borders and threat embassies or whatever, the school wrote to him that they are not sure they are going to have all face-to-face lectures. There are two things. Either he made a decision to decline and reapply next year when the global crisis is over, or he paid tuition and then subscribe for online lectures. And then he came and met me that his family told him that since they have the amount of money they had to spend, that he should decline. That he should turn down the offer because there is no need taking classes online when you are not there. You know, in Africa, we send our children abroad, people when they go abroad, they'll be working and they might send some money while in school. But if you stay in Kabul, you're taking that, they're paying those amount of school fees. No matter with somebody there,
yes,
it looks like. So he came and told me, I was in Goya, in the branch in Goya, the office in Goya. I told him that no. But this is his father and mother would go and pay the school fees. They have given him instruction. I told him, no, don't. Tell that the school that you are interested in the course and you will be available for the course. And he said to me that, what do I do, daddy? I believe you, I don't know how to do my mother and father. I said, even if you have said, just tell them that's what I have said. If they do whatever, just tell them that's what I've said. And the young man believed him. They sent the letters and sent that the way the online classes will start, the school fees, the one that they should send it. He said, the money has been made. I said, send it. Without test money, your parents give you, send the money. Don't worry about the way another one will come. Send it. Amazingly how it is. Do you know, before God and man, I speak to you, last 2 weeks, they wrote him a letter that the school for the program have decided that the classes will work on us. They sent him a letter and that their embassy in the country has opened. He can come, classes are supposed to start this August. If he had canceled that admission, then, this is it, then, he supposed, there is no Swedish embassy in Cameroon, he's supposed to go to Nigeria to get a Swedish visa. He has to compile documents, affidavit, all the other stuff of sponsorship. They sent him a letter from the school. He wrote the embassy to find out when can he come for appointment. The embassy asked him if he has the number, whatever. He does not have just the admission letter, He wrote the letter to the embassy, sent the letter. Has not gone with any document. Last night, he wrote me, Daddy, and found me a letter the embassy, the message the embassy sent to him. Maybe after, let me read it on my phone. Your resident permit has been granted. No document submitted.
Yes.
No document submitted. Just come for your biometric and take your visa and fly. No affidavit, no financial form sponsored. Visa granted before God and before man. I woke up at midnight. I began turning around. I know that I preached miracle, but that one surprised me. You understand? It surprised me because I know the procedure for certain things to happen. I am too informed on ambassadorial procedures and document issues. That one shocked me. I'm here to prophesy to someone. There is a shocking miracle coming your way. I said there is a shocking miracle coming your way. I'm speaking to you. I'm speaking to you. I am speaking to you. Friends, how did he get it? He got it through instructions. Before heaven and before man. Before heaven and before man, nothing. I came today to your church And they said, is Saul also among the prophets? After the encounter with the prophets, when Saul left Samuel's presence, the power of God came upon Saul. And they said, is Saul also among the prophets? The prophet said, and said, is Saul also among the prophets? I'm not hearing you pray. You're saying to God, I'm not living with the same. Awesome God. Glorious God.
Where have you gone from your church?